Hey everyone, today I'll be demoing how you can use your Google account to mint a PKP and store an encryption condition with the Lit network. So this will be an entirely free process for you as a user. All you have to do is sign in with your Google account and then mint a PKP against our what's called the relayer server, and again using the relayer server to store the encryption condition. The Relayer server is a fully centralized server developed and maintained by the Lit Protocol team. The purpose of this Relayer server is to facilitate and subsidize some user requests in the near future. But overall, it's going to be facilitating quite a nice UX. So let's begin. I'm going to first click this button on the left here, and this is by no means the finalized UI. This is just something that we put up really quickly just to demo this whole functionality. So I'm going to click my Google account, and I've logged in right now back to this web application here. And you can see the status update here saying that we're waiting for the auth completion. So what it's doing is that upon the Google sign-in successfully completing, this web front-end is actually making a network request to our Relayer server, asking it to start the minting process. And under the hood, the Relayer server is sending a transaction to the PKP-related smart contracts to generate a new PKP. The reason why we're waiting for the auth to complete is so that that transaction can have a certain number of blocks to be confirmed on top of it in order for it to be deemed confirmed by the Relayer server. Specifically, right now we're waiting for 8 blocks, and as you can see here by the fourth poll, we've detected that, hey, the transaction has more than 8 blocks confirmed in the backend. We can determine it to be finalized. So the Relayer server is in the latest network request saying back to this front end, the status has succeeded, it's a terminal state, and it's also returned some useful information regarding the PKP that's minted. For example, you can see that the ETH address is this one, as also reflected on the front end here, and also there's a public key associated with it. What we can do next is actually just very conveniently grab, this is a transaction hash in the pull request here, and we can go to Mumbai and check that it is indeed the same transaction that we kicked off a minute ago, and it has at least 8 confirmations, 8 block confirmations on top of it. So the next thing we can do is to again use the Relayer server to have my transaction to store an encryption condition be completely subsidized. All we have to do is click this button right here, and it will make a network request to the Relayer server to have it do that on my behalf as a user. So you can see that there's some network requests being made here. And for the purposes of this demo, we are optimistically returning back a status update saying we've successfully done this and sent out the TX from the Relayer. Again, for the purposes of this demo, we're not waiting for the 8 block confirmations at this step. So to sum everything up, this is the end of the demo. We've just managed to use Google sign-in to do 2 things that usually would require users to pay, but it now, using the Relayer server maintained by the Lit Protocol team, minting a PKP and storing an encryption condition is completely free. And you can only imagine lots more use cases to open up and to be designed for when we facilitate more and more interactions beyond storing an encryption condition. So thanks for viewing.